Welcome everyone in the second lecture on probability distribution. In previous lecture we have just seen what is a random variable and one example. In today's session we will discuss what is meant by probability distribution, then two types of random variable, one is a discrete and the second one is a continuous random variable, and probability distribution of a discrete random variable and simple example we would like to see.
What is meant by probability distribution? Okay. So before we go for this probability distribution, as I discussed, I would like to first discuss types of the random variable. Now there are two types of random variable. One is discrete random variable and the second one is continuous random variable. Okay. Now what is discrete random variable? Basically capital X be a random variable if your x takes the values which are finite or countably infinite, say x1, x2 and so on xn, then x is called as a discrete random variable. Let's take an example of a tossing of two fair coins. In the tossing of two fair coins, our sample space is this. Okay. Now, if my random variable x, which denotes number of heads, then what are the possible values of x? Either there is no head, that means 0. There is one head, that is HT or DH. Or two heads are there. So 0, 1 and 2. These are the possible values of x. That means my x1 is 0, x2 is 1 and x3 is 2. So there are only finite values. Three values are there. So that means there are only finite values. Okay. Now, suppose I am going to define another experiment. I am going to toss a coin and I will stop unless I get a tell. Okay. Jo paranta mala tells mirat nahi, to paranta mi ha random experiment continue karna. What are the possibilities I am getting? In first toss, I am getting tell. I will stop. Or first toss, there is H. Second toss, there is tell. Or what is the possibility? First H, then again H, and then T. So I require the three tosses for this. Suppose this is not. Then first, second, third. Everywhere I am getting heads. And for fourth time, I am getting tell. And so on like that. So what happens here? I can count these number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. I can count them. But this sequence is infinite. Okay, so this is called countable infinite. So if your x takes either finite values or countable infinite values like x1, x2, xn and so on, then such variable is called as a discrete random variable. Okay, now what is continuous random variable? Let capital X be a random variable which takes uncountably infinite values. What is uncountably infinite? I'll just give another example which is not exactly of this type. Say, see on the real line, minus infinity to plus infinity, here you have a 0, 0 to 1. Can you tell me how many real numbers with between 0 and 1? We cannot say, because there are uncountable infinites and we cannot count those numbers which are between 0 and 1. Someone will say the next to 0 is 0.1. Someone will say no, it is 0.01. Someone will say no, it is 0.001. Someone will say 0.001. Up to what? We cannot say the next to the 0. So this is what countable infinite is. Okay. So if your observations of, or say the values of x are uncountably infinite, then such random variables are called as a continuous. We will discuss this part afterward in detail. Now we will move to the probability distribution. Now before I define this probability distribution, I just like to discuss one simple example for the clear cut understanding of this. Let's have a look. I have said 10 cards, C1, C2, C3 up to C10. So there are 10 cards I have. Each card is having some number. I wrote some number on this. Say 3, 4, 3, 2, 5, 4, 3, 1, 4, 3. That means the card 1 will have the number 3. Card 2 will have the number 4. Card 3 will have the number 3. On card 4, the number would be 2. Card 4 will have number 2. Card 5, there is a number 5, like that. Okay? Now the experiment is, select one card. Select one card out of 10 cards. As there are 10 cards, select one of them. Is my random experiment. Such manner that each card is equally likely to be selected. What is the condition? Or what is the extra information? Each card is equally likely. Okay, so that's a very important. Now, capital X be a random variable. I'm now defining a capital X, which is a random variable, which denotes the number on selected card. It denotes a number on the selected card. Then what is capital X of C1? Or what is the value I am assigning to the C1 with the random variable X? Is its number. What is the number on C1? 3. X of C2 will be 4. X of C3 will be 3. X of C4 will be 2. X of C5 will be 5. X of C6 will be 4. X of C7 will be 3. X of C8 will be 1. X of C9 will be 4. And what is there for 10th card? It is again 3. Okay. So this way I am assigning a number to each of the card under the random variable number on the selected card. Okay. Now, X can text the values either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. These are the choices for X. So now you see there are only 5 numbers, so they are finite in number, so this is a discrete random variable. Okay. Now upon which card is selected, therefore, so this assigning of the number is depends on the which card is selected. So therefore, when I say the value of X is 5, this is possible when I select the card C5. The value of X2, that means the value of X is 2, is possible only if we are selecting the card 4. The value of X will be 3. This is possible only if I select either C1 or C3 or C7 or C10, like this. As it is assumed that card selection is equally likely, can you tell me what is the probability that card C8 gets selected? Can you tell me that C8 gets selected? Just have a look here. C8. What is the number assigned to it? 1. Okay. So, how many cards are there having the number 1? Only one card. But how many total cards are there? 10. So what is the probability? 1 by 10. So therefore, the probability of X is equal to 1 or X takes the value 1 is 1 by 10. Okay? So therefore, this situation can also be written as P of X is equal to 1 is equal to 1 by 10. Okay? I hope this idea that probability of card C8 is selected. C8 is selected means what? X takes the value 1. So what is the probability that X will take the value 1? It is 1 by 10. Similarly, we can have the probability of selecting the cards C1, C3, C7, C10. See, C1, C3, C7 and C10. Everywhere the number is 3. Okay, so how many cards are there? 4 cards out of 10 I am selecting. So the probability of X is equal to 3 is 4 by 10. So this way we can define P of X is equal to 1 is 1 by 10, p of x is equal to 2 is equal to 1 by 10, p of x is equal to 3 is 4 by 10, p of x is equal to 4 is equal to 3 by 10, and the probability of the value of x becomes 5 is again 1 by 10. So thus, a random variable assigns a value to the card along with the corresponding probability. This is called probability distribution. Okay. Now let's move to the definition of this probability distribution. Let x be a discrete random variable. It takes the values x1, x2 and so on, xn and so on, with each possible outcome with each possible outcome xi, we associate a number to it, pi, for I is equal to 1, 2 and so on up to n and so on like that. Okay, that is pi is equal to p of x is equal to xi is equal to pi. This is called as the probability of x takes the value xi. Okay, so this pi is a small letter. Here I am writing it is in capital letter. Here I can write capital P of xi, and here it is a small pi. Okay, I'll just rewrite this statement again. Small pi is equal to capital P of x is equal to xi is equal to capital P of xi. Either you can write this way or this way, but their values is a small pi. Okay, now these pi's must satisfy two conditions. The condition one is all pi's must be greater than or equal to 0 for 1, 2, 3 up to so on n. And if I take a summation of all these pi's from 1 to infinity, then that should be a 1. Okay. Now you can have the example of this. This is my p1, p2, p3, p4 and p5. So 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10 plus 4 by 10 plus 3 by 10 plus 1 by 10. So 1 plus 1, 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. So 10 by 10, that is 1. Okay. And you can see all these pi's are greater than 0. So hence this is a probability distribution. So the pair xi, pi is called as probability distribution. Okay, now probability distribution function of a discrete random variable that is capital P of x is equal to xi. So we can say only capital P here. So this P is a function called as a probability mass function. In general, PMF. That means we are assigning some mass to every member xi through this capital P. Okay, let's take one simple example of finding the probability distribution of a tossing of a fair coin